And I want to start here by talking about timeline. Now, I know most of you are familiar with Timeline. You've tried it out before. Timeline is now ramping to millions of people as part of our April update. And so with Timeline, the basic idea is that the things that you do on your PC or other devices are available in a simple click from the taskbar. You can scroll back through time, see everything you were working on, and just click to resume. Now, the key idea here, though, is that Timeline is based on the Microsoft Graph, and therefore, it enables cross-device experiences. Here you can see I've got my iPhone out. I'm going to do some browsing in Edge for iOS. I'm going to look at a Word document. And when I do, those Microsoft 365 experiences, they post that activity data into the Microsoft Graph, and then when I switch devices and go to my timeline, I'll see those activities. So there's my Word document, and there's the web browsing I was doing. This is relevant, of course, to all of you, because now is the time for your apps to be posting that activity data to the graph as well. As Timeline ramps to tons of people, on mobile and on the PC, we want that experience to work for all the things they use. Now, you might be wondering, now that this is out, what happens next? Well, with the graph data in the cloud, we're going to begin experimenting with some features that will reason against that and do things to help end users be more effective. Like in this example here, you'll see we're working on an idea that'll come to an insider build soon, where Cortana can make proactive suggestions about where you would pick up where you would left off based on your frequency or intensity of working on particular things.